So if you first take a look at the equation, a to the x power is equal to 16. Well, the answer for this right here is just x is equal to 2, right? No, this is actually not correct. Because if you put 2 in here, we get 8 to the second power, which means 8 times 8, and that's actually 64, not 16. So 2 is not the answer. So how exactly are we supposed to solve this though? Here we have an exponential equation because the x is in the exponent, and in this particular one, I'm going to show you guys two ways to do it. The first way is we can actually make the bases equal, and then the second one is we can actually use the logarithm. So start with the first way. Here, notice that we have 8, which is the same as 2 times 2 times 2, which is just the same as 2 to the third power. So we have this and then raised to the x power. Now, for the 16, can we also make it with base 2? Yes, because 16 is the same as 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is 2 to the 4th power. That's very nice. Now, 2 to the 3rd power to the x power, by one of the rule of exponents, we can multiply the powers. So this is just 2 to the 3 times x. Have a look. Here we have the bases equal to each other. In this case, that means the exponents must be equal. And the reason because is that when we have an exponential function, it's 1 to 1. Meaning, if the outputs are equal, that means the input have to be equal. Exponential functions are 1 to 1. That's why. So we can just say that 3x is equal to 4. And now we can just divide both sides by 3. X is equal to 4 over 3. And then we are done. Really? Are we really done? Well, I'm going to check the answer for you to convince you guys that this is actually the answer. So here is the check. We are going to check if x is equal to 4 over 3 really works. Put this back here, 8 to the 4 over 3 power, like this. Okay, to work out this fractional exponent, what we are going to do first is take care of the denominator of the exponent. We have the 3 right here. This turns out to be a cube root. So this is the cube root. And then let's do the number right here. Work out cube root of 8 first, and then do the 4th power on outside. Because when you do this, the numbers will become smaller. Cube root of 8 is just equal to 2. And then raise that to the 4th power, we end up with 16, which is, of course, what we are looking for. So this is indeed correct. Now, what is the logarithm way? Let's have a look. So here we go. Again, we have a to the x is equal to 16. X is in the exponent. Then in this case, we can try to take the logarithm on both sides. And because the base for this exponent part right here is 8, we are going to take log with the same base 8. And of course, we do the same thing to both sides. So that this and that can cancel, and the x will just be by itself. You can look at it like this way, they cancel and get the x by itself, or you can look at it as you put the x to the front and log base 8 of 8 is equal to 1. Either way, you just get x by itself. And then on the right hand side, we just have to figure out log base 8 of 16. And in fact, the log way is much better in the sense that because we don't get nice numbers all the time, so once you do the log way, right here you can use a calculator to figure that out, but here we can actually do it without a calculator, so let's continue with that. To do so, you can use the change of base formula. So this right here is the same as x is equal to, I can do log, and this is just a regular log of this number here, over log of this number here. Okay, and then for the 16, we can look at this as log of 2 to the 4th power, and then for the 8, that's the same as log of 2 to the 3rd power. And then by one of the log properties, we can take the power and then bring that to the front, like that. And that's exactly what I was saying earlier, we could put the x to the front, and log 8 of 8 is just 1. So we are doing that right here as well. So this becomes 4 times log 2 over 3 times log 2. And right here, notice log 2, because 4 times this, 3 times that, so we can reduce this out. So the final answer is 4 over 3. Just like this. So the key right here is that we can use the change of base formula to go from here to here. And the reason I pick the regular log on the calculator, this log, so I'll make a note right here. When we have log, this log, this means we have log with base 10. Especially if you use a regular scientific calculator or graphing calculator, it means log 10. But in fact, you can also have used the ln log on the calculator, and that's the natural log. This right here means we have log with a special number e, which is about 2.718828, so on. You could also have written this as ln 16 over ln 8. That's fine too. And then this right here still works. Okay? Oh yeah, I'll also show you guys a fast way to do this. So if you don't want to go through all that, here is another way. If you look at this, I could also write this down as log. Just change the 8 to 2 to the third power. And then the 16 is 2 to the 4th power. And then the magic is, if the bases are equal, you can just look at this power over that power, and you say the answer is 4 over 3. Why does this work? Because you can use the change of base formula to get this, to get this, to get this, to get that. So it's pretty much the same thing, but this right here, it's actually much faster. Okay, now I'm done.